You are. Oh, close your eyes and begin to tell the Lord that, Lord, give me the grace to stand for you wherever I am. Wherever I find myself, give me the grace to stand for you. Open your mouth and begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth, begin to pray. Bible reading. Open your mouth, begin to pray. Open your mouth, begin to tell the Lord, give me the grace to stand for you. Wherever I find myself, wherever I am, give me the grace to stand for you to the end of my life. Open your mouth and begin to tell the Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, every Goliath in my destiny, die by fire. In the name of Jesus, every Goliath in my destiny, die by fire. In the name of Jesus, die by fire. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Powers that are promoting my problems, die. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Powers promoting my problem, die. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Any power attacking my greatness, be consumed by fire. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The message you are going to hear today, I want to encourage you to apply that message immediately. They are not abstract thoughts of indolent philosophers. No. Praise the name of the Lord. They are not what? They are not abstract thoughts of indolent philosophers. They are biblical principles. These principles, if you can apply it, your life become a great exhibit. Your life become a great resume of assets that can facilitate your promotion and advancement. Therefore, I want to listen attentively. If I've ever watched a particular football match, the most skillful and very good player, they often attack him more than other people. Isn't it? They will concentrate on him. Praise the Lord. Satan can lead hundreds of people and concentrate on an individual because the fulfillment of the destiny of that person will wreak havoc on his destiny. Praise the Lord. Most times people ask, why am I passing through what I'm passing through? It's because there are certain things in your life worth contending for. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
10 ways to spend your days prosperously. What did I say? What is the title of the message? 10 ways. I've said it. If you can apply this message, for those of you who are not writing, I pity you. Praise the name of the Lord. Because the faintest pen is better than what? The best brain. Praise the name of the Lord. The faintest pen is what? Better than the best brain. 10 ways to spend your days prosperously. In the popular book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse number 1, it says, everything has its own time. There is a time to plant and a time to harvest. There is a plant to do what? To plant to harvest. Everybody go to that place, Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse number 11. Are we there? Read, everybody. Everybody. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse number 11. Sorry, verse 1. There is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to do what? To uproot. That is why you have what to call timetable. You have what? In schools, we have timetable. Also, for particular programs, you have time schedules. There are some homes where they have full timetable. I want to encourage you and challenge you to listen to this message. Go to the Facebook, go to the YouTube, listen to them over and over again. If you cannot manage a day, how can you manage a week? What did I say?
You cannot manage a day, how can you manage a week?
That's why I say, make sure you jot something down, don't deceive yourselves. These are the principles people have lived over their life and their destiny changed. If you cannot manage a day, how can you manage a week? I want
want to give you practical tips. We have been teaching message of prosperity and so forth. But we want to, you know, people have been criticized, but in a way that shall be challenged, and when you do well, we can say you want to move the work of God further. Better listen to me. There are people listening right now, people from overseas, there are the Zooms, there are people from other towns that also listen to me. If you cannot manage a week, how do you manage a month? If you cannot manage a month, how can you manage a year? If you cannot manage a year, how can you manage a lifetime? 2020 is going right now. And I've told you several times that 2021 will not come in bulk. It comes in seconds, in seconds. We are pushing it. Why are you preparing for it? Praise the name of the Lord. So if you cannot manage 2020, how will you manage 2021? That is the question I'm posing to you. Listen to this message, you need to organize your life. You need to adjust your life. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our mommy Shola, can you remember the time I came here this morning today? Can you remember? I was already in the morning before I moved to Abdullah and pushing the eye. Last week, as I was preaching, people are coming. I was on the road, I blessed them at Victoria Land, and I zoomed off. We are here, we are liberated. We must learn the principle like people like Warren Buffett. People like what? And the owner of Microsoft, what is the debate? There are principles I want to share with you. So please write if you want to be prosperous. What did I say? If you want to be what? Yesterday, I look at places like Hawaii, Honolulu. Okay? It's an island, the 50th state in America. I like that beautiful place. I was visualizing myself, seeing myself there, moving up and down. I look at it on the globe something. I also look at Kingston. In what we call it in Jamaica. Some of the places in Kingston, they are just like Makoko, in Jamaica, and so on and so forth. Praise the name of the Lord. We come to that one. Praise the name of the Lord. We have electric car right now. I pray God will give electric car in Jesus' name. You not be complaining of what we call, you know, fuel and so on and so forth. Rascal for Suka Payalashia. Listen attentively. Next week is a deliverance message. We have to imbalance. I want to see prosperous people. Praise the name of the Lord. There are people listening to us right now and they shall be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I like to say, Pastor, the message will work on it and we are hearing testimonies. Yes, we have a new manager in 2021. I said, 2020, it's coming. I know, I actually understand people said they will still continue to log in. I appreciate them, okay? And when you are coming, make sure you observe all our full protocols. We must realize that the days, they make up the week. And the weeks, they make up the months. And the month, they make up the lifetime. They make up what? In agriculture, that's what they call annual plants, biennial and what? Perennial. The way we live determines our habits. You cannot just wake up one day and become wealthy. No. You cannot just wake up one day and become prosperous. The way you live, the habits, they will crystallize to help you to achieve your goals in life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Number one way to spend your days, okay, you must wake up with high level of motivation. Say, I will wake up with high level of motivation. I cannot hear you. I want to congratulate for people that join us at the beach. If you can paralyze certain activities at night, you wake up with joy. But in the field with all kinds of foodstuffs, you wake up disjointed, disoriented. You can wake up on a daily basis, pray for 15 minutes. I'm not saying you pray for 1 hour. Aggressively, shout hallelujah. Wake up with high level of motivation. If you wake up disjointed, you wake up demotivated. That day is already gone. It's already bad. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. The Bible says, with joy shall we draw from the well of salvation. That's what the Bible says. Poor people, they never prepare for the day. What are you preparing for tomorrow right now? They just wake up and make a fire brigade, they live a fire brigade life. Say, I refuse to live a fire brigade life. The fire service never does anything until there is a crisis. They never what? If you have not planned what you are going to do tomorrow, something is wrong with you. Your destiny cannot is in thunder. Don't stop living a fire brigade life. Say, I refuse to live a fire brigade life. spend your time to listen to this type of message. Go to our channels, our YouTube, our Facebook. Press your like and listen to it. Make your comment. They help your life to move on. Number two, wake up to set goals every day. Rich people, they set goals. Not just any person, I want to do other things. Select 10 things and then hashtag 3 of them. Focus on those things and challenges, and then you will see results in prosperity. Number three, focus on few things. Rich people, they focus on few things. If you want to go far, focus on few things. A rolling stone gathers no moose. Those who are going somewhere, they take little things and maximize their effort until they break through. Okay? Nobody has ever asked Bill Gates why he focuses on software. He's not producing cars. Is he producing cars? Answer me now. Focus on few things. The remaining part of that. Focus on few things. He's focused. He comes with concept ideas that can help you to move forward. I listen to so many things. Okay? I research to so many things. Thank God for online things. Praise the name of the Lord. Number four, open yourself to self-education and improvement on a daily basis. Curiosity is essential to your creativity. Ask questions. Don't just agree that 2 + 2 is equal to 4. Ask questions, investigate, find out. Go beyond the degrees in your hand. Ask questions about the business you are doing. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Invest in your minds. What did I say? Invest. Try to enrich your mind with learning. Some they will spend money to buy expensive shoes, whereas their mind is very poor. If you invest your mind, God can provide you so much money that you can buy the factory of the person that is producing the shoes for you. Number five, try to show no to things that will not add value to your life. Praise the name of the Lord. Be very clear on what you want on a daily basis. Say no to people that want to come to us and waste your time. Don't spend your time doing nothing. Don't spend your what? I had a lecturer when I was in university. He said he spent his time, he was busy doing nothing. It's a very strange statement. He said he was busy what? Doing nothing. I took a course of them, I think a comparative public administration or so. Dr. Henry Akil. Okay? He said he spent his time doing nothing. Praise the name of the Lord. It is amazing that people don't realize that if they give you time and money, what are you going to take? Eh? If they give you time and money, what are you going to take? Eh? I know someone will take money. Whereas if you take time, praise that you can multiply that money. You can bring value to your time. A lot of people, they cannot manage their time. If you cannot manage your hour, you cannot manage your day. If you cannot manage your day, you cannot manage your week. If you cannot manage your week, you cannot manage your month. Once a week is lost, you have lost something. Today is tomorrow you spoke about yesterday. What did I say? I cannot hear you. Today, December 15th is the tomorrow you spoke about December 14th. I want your life to get value. Things are happening all over the world and they are not friendly. I listened at America, over, I think one day they had 173 cases of coronavirus. I mean, that was the worst. The mortuaries are filled up. Nobody, every place to admit people. Today is the tomorrow you spoke about yesterday. Learn how to spend the days. You know, they just finished the election, so people went and voted without putting nose masks. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. God gives you the brain. God gives you the mind to think. You may have your own judgment concerning this thing I'm teaching. Next week, we shall be doing deliverance, dreams, causes, destiny. Don't worry. At VG2,
If you have not been joining the vigil, you are doing a lot, you are not helping yourself. A week is lost to some people. Today, tomorrow, we spoke about yesterday. If you want to know how to handle work, you need to know how to say no things that are not of value to you. Learn to say no. Very, very important. There are so many people that entertain or people come and waste their time with all kinds of joint thoughts and so on. Where there are so many things for you to write about, to think about. You see, I listened to Steve Kanaki, who was reporting about American elections. I was thinking, how can you report those kinds of things in a Nigerian election? If you press one state, you will see that state will change the electoral college points. If you press Georgia with 60 electoral points, it will change what this person will have and so on and so forth. I was looking at how can we adapt to Nigeria? This is happening. How can we be a political consultant to one person's contested that will pay me something of value? I was watching him on Dr. Shoulder. I can see little things that are very, very scary to this place. You need to do what? Your mind. It's time for pastors to wake up to know that they are leaders. That you are even more brilliant than people in authority. My mission is for life to be better, for you to become a comfortable millionaire. Praise the name of the Lord. To become what? That is it. Second is adjusting people's life to poverty. WBEB because says something. He said to be poor is to live a hard life. But to be poor in the lack of a dollar is to do what? At the bottom of what? Of hardship. He was a prisoner in America. And I missed his message. I paid one rent in California. A studio room, one bedroom apartment, and then two bedroom apartment. I go to Los Angeles. That to be a poor man, a poor race in the back of the dollar, so what? To be at the bottom of hardship. An apartment, except for the apartments, are about $1,000 per month. That $1,000 per month can take you for 2 years. Isn't it? Answer me. I said last week, in South Africa, 4%, they were controlling 2% of the wealth before the fall of apartheid. After the fall of the apartheid, 4% had that control of the GDP. The mere fact that the policy has changed, the mere fact that a particular barrier has broken, not talking anybody will benefit. But you need to change your mind to adjust your mind. This is your best time for you. I said this is the best time for you. I've been talking about demon next week. We have to be balanced. You are loving. Yes, I know. Don't worry. I know what is on. Don't worry. Okay? We are prepared. This is our best. This is our what? Our best time. We will not beg in Jesus' name. Yeah. Your children will not beg in Jesus' name. Yeah. I sent something to the church groups about some jobs, something else, some friends. Some people want to do something. So, God bless you. Apply. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. To be a poor race in the land of the dollar is to go at what? The bottom of hardship. You will not be a poor race in Jesus' name. The black race is not a lacking race. We have brain. We have what? I tried to look at the DNA of Kamala, what do you call this? The new vice president. You know, if you got good DNA, the people in Caribbean, they can do their genetic DNA. They say, hey, 10% from Nigeria, 10% from Sierra Leone, and so on and so forth. They are trying to do that. Praise the name of the Lord. It's also a black group from Jamaica, and Jamaicans are basically Africans. If you go to places like what the Cuba, you see Otumare, Kenekon, and so on and so forth. Brazil, I think, I didn't even know that 97, up close to 97 million, they're up to their Yoruba people over there. Shout hallelujah. Number six. Successful people, rich people, they package so many things into the early hours of the day. They package so many things to what? To the early hours of what of the day. Brothers and sisters, before the day blows open, they have done so many things. They package so many to do in the early hours of what of the day. So that there'll be no distraction. There'll be no what? If you can package so many things to the early hours of the day, okay, you can be successful. Before 10, you have done so many things. 11, they already call you as a pastor. Say, pastor, I have this also dream. By 11, everybody is disturbing you. They package so many things to what? Into early hours of the day.
know how to pack things into the early hours before the station. It is a serene time. This what? A serene time. No much noise. That's why I pray. God will make our environment conducive to Jesus' name. Before I say, oh, so the 10 person, 10 person. I say, it's just going to go back. He go down there. Then get it. He kill my papa. He kill my mama. That's what take everybody go inside. When you begin to listen to the blast of the stereos, you package so many things into that. You know what I'm talking about. Wake up early and do something. Before you start distractions, mama will start calling. Papa will start calling everybody. If you know what you are going to do tomorrow, operate on these principles. Praise the name of the Lord. Because by 12, the distraction already coming. People are already waiting for you. I'm taking some people like Bill Gates, Warren Buffett. This is the way to operate. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord.
By the time I came in the morning, there was no more door. I think I just took about 15 minutes to go back to our estate also too. Please, change your life and change your destiny. Praise the name of the Lord. People like Warren Buffett and Bill Gates, they are early morning people. They are what?
Early morning people.
Early morning people. Somebody say, I'm teaching, it takes quite a long time to study, to only to bring them together. And they have worked for me. They've what? They've worked for me. People like Warren Buffett, Bill Gates, they are early morning people. They realize that when the day is serene, there is less disturbance. Less what? Early in the morning today, I've already woken up, I read Lamentation to some place. Before I just come to that place, I'm hitting the road. Everybody is still young. Even Baba, you are still young. Everybody is young. You can achieve so much. You can write so much early in the morning. You can easily define your goals. It is as if you are listening to yourself. You are solidifying when you wake up early in the morning. You are listening to yourself. Praise the name of the Lord. One of the ways to spend your day prosperous to do what? Packing so many things into what? Into the early hours of the day. You do your praise and worship. You pray to your Bible. You take, you command the day and so on and so forth. That's why the book of Joseph, have you commanded the day? Praise the name of the Lord. Number 7, visualize success. There is power in your thinking and your talking. There is connection between them. Praise the name of the Lord. As you are sitting down, imagine yourself in far places. I go through so many things. I look at San Francisco, very beautiful place. I look at Oakland. I look at Pittsburgh. You look at, you know, Pittsburgh is an industrial district. Go to those streets. Visualize success. When you visualize success, you see yourself, you know, in Honolulu. That's Hawaii. In the beach there with the winds blowing. And you see boys selling ice cream, say, bring ice cream for me. And then begin to look at it. Take me to the palace of the last king here before the American make the 50th state in the place. You look at those things. You visualize yourself. Shout hallelujah. This thing, there is a lot of things there, but people are using for evil. You visualize yourself. And then when you visualize yourself, you begin to take efforts. You begin to do what? Don't visualize, but take efforts to accomplish it. There's electric car in the place right now. You need to visualize yourself. In electric car, there's a working or driverless car. What is the cost of electric car that was just bought during the week? What's the cost? What is the cost? I want someone to find out the cost and give you next week. I'll give us an assignment. You begin to visualize yourself. Say, well, how can I be, you know, the fuel that is going up and down every day? Why can I be wasting my time on it? Because if we charge that vehicle, if we take it from here to Wally before you do another charging, praise the name of the Lord. If I follow me, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I will visualize success every day. If you are coming here, you are visualizing like poverty and employment, something is wrong with you. I've told you, don't just come in for deliverance, come in for money matters. I've given cancer. Somebody see this is another thing they teach in our four walls.
Stop running about. No worries, we will pray deliverance prayers. Okay?
Visualize it. You begin to be hungry and be thirsty for it. Many people, they never use their brain and mind to achieve anything. Use it to visualize success. Expect it. Put effort on it and let it happen. Visualize for only another line in Badalbi. Call those people that are saying you can pay for 3 years. Pay 10,000 per day or per month, per week. And finish it and become your property. And when the price goes up, say, sell it for me. And put the money in my bank account. Those are the things we call MSI. What do I call it? Multiple source of income. We have money IQ and money EQ. There are different things. You are sleeping under this message.
Shout hallelujah.
These are the habits of wealthy people. They look at how problem can be solved. They look at how product and services they are handling will bring wealth to them. Your passion may not make you wealthy. There are so many people that say, I have a passion. Go and solve problems and wealth will come. Solve problems with a passion, then wealth will come. So many people, they have music, they've composed, have passion for music. How many people are we hearing there? Very few. A lot of people, they're going about with songs, but nobody heard their songs. That one will not be your passion in Jesus. That one will not be your passion in Jesus' name. Find problems of the plenty for the church. The Zoom office is in California. Depend upon the prevailing exchange rate. Praise the name of the Lord. As at the last time, they have made $5 billion. They are doing online questions and teachings. But God to answer, don't let it become an instrument of iniquity. Praise the name of the Lord. Number 8, avoid junk food. A lot of people, they ruin their lives with junk food. If you want to be financially successful, be very careful what you eat. Poor people don't do exercise. They don't care about what they eat. Praise the name of the Lord. Coronavirus has killed a lot of people. There's a particular community, especially the community of black and poor in America and the UK, that this thing dealt with them. If you look at the statistics of people over there, it affected the color and the black so much. Ask questions. What you eat, it can affect your life or health. And if you're not able to work, you're not able to make the money. Ask questions about the nutritional value, okay, of what you are taking, because it can affect your capacity to spend your days. If you spend 10 hours running on the bed because of one back pain or because of diligence, you will not like it. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. For the upcoming generations, I mean the 24 generations who are going to succeed, you cannot operate on a low energy food. You need things that can give you energy to work. What is the strength? You need strength to work. Know the kind of food that can give you energy so that you can work on a daily basis. What is the essence of creating wealth and you are not allowed to enjoy it? You must stay to enjoy your wealth. I said you will stay to enjoy your wealth. Know the food you eat that will give you energy. Start asking the nutritionist, not the doctor. What would I need to do so that I can get out of it? Jumping up and down. Somebody said, a 40-year-old boy that is doing like this. Take it. No! Go and work on it today so that the bands, you will know what? And they see you, say, wow, how old are you? This is at my age. They say, hey, you don't look like that. Work on it. You are what we eat. And the sickness of the body is what you eat, what you drink, and what you breathe in. A lot of people, they don't do exercise. Praise the name of the Lord. But you see why people, they go, shout hallelujah. Any power attacking your greatness shall be wasted in Jesus' name. Psalm 71 verse 21 says, that Lord will increase your greatness and comfort on every side. That is the thing. Praise the name of the Lord. Avoid gambling. The poor people, they always expect luck. What did I say? Every
Everywhere you go, you see lottery, you see betting machines. Most people you see there, they are poor people. Am I saying the truth? Answer me. Early in the morning, you will see there, they make contribution everywhere, every hour to somebody who's becoming a mega millionaire, billionaire. They make what? Contributions to somebody every hour, to somebody that becomes what? A mega millionaire, billionaire every day. When we're in the village in those days, they be playing in Liverpool versus Atlanta. Shout hallelujah. Early in the morning, you see that they will cluster around that place. Close your eyes, everybody. If you have gambled this year, raise up your hand. Don't deceive yourself. Raise up your hand now. Shout hallelujah. God bless you, okay? Praise the name of the Lord. Every hour, you are making a contribution to somebody who is becoming what? A mega millionaire, what? Billionaire. You become a millionaire in Jesus' name. You see, there are computer programmers that manipulate betting machines. I listened to somebody who said, he said, why are you working? He said, I'm a computer programmer in one lottery company. And the person said, there's a way they manipulate those computers. Thank you. So, listen. You can go and teach anybody that is betting. This is, go on, tell them. There's a way they manipulate that machine. Okay? So they must have created a system that will give people little wins. And when you are getting little wins, they will encourage that person to be playing it until the person is shocked. Until the person, you part with your money. I win 10,000 this week. Hey, I win 5,000 this week. Little wins. And the person will be shocked. He say, okay, let me go play 100,000. That's it. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. My brother, my sister, and lastly, be very careful of social media. Okay? It's another distraction. All this reality TV. I told you that time there's a difference between class and work status. If you go to some of these places and you see the largest TV screens, go to Marco on top of water, you see there the kind of TV we see in Banana Island. They are using money to buy status. You can buy status, but not class. And I want you to know, but when you are really classy, you can afford, you know where you are. Millionaire of this day, they go in jeans and slippers. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. So, people will go and buy single-play shoes of, what do you call it, 250,000 or a wig of 450,000. It's okay. And you know your conditions. You know that if you invest that money, you can make more, much millions. Praise the name of the Lord. So, the very worship of a TV, social media, they can waste your time. Social media is very educative. Social media is very powerful. Yes, I spent quite some time last week. I look at some countries, know what is happening here to educate my mind. Okay? At that time, you know, I educate my mind. You can use it for that. So if you form these habits, your life will change. Let me look at globality. Wake up with high level of motivation. That's number one, how to spend your days prosperously. If you wake up looking morose and taciturn, looking sad, that day is already finished. Number two, set goals on a daily basis. Your goals will determine where you are going, okay, and how to get there. Number three, focus on few things. A rolling stone that no moves. Number four, open your life to education and self-improvement. Open your life to what? Even if you are selling garri, there are people selling garri now, they will not put granite. They miss sugar. Go to Slovakia, you will sit here. Okay? Try to say no to things that will not add value to your life. Not only that, make sure you pass so many things to the early hours of the day before what? Destruction. And then visualize success. Then make effort to accomplish them. See yourself driving an electric car. See yourself enjoy your holiday in Las Vegas. See yourself in Los Angeles. See yourself in Netherlands and so on and so forth. Okay? Visualize it. Say after coronavirus, you know, this life, you don't know when it's going to end. And then you enjoy yourself a bit and get ready for heaven. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Not only that, avoid junk food. We are all guilty of this. Then avoid gambling. Avoid what? There are Christians that are still gambling, you know. They will make donations to what? All kinds of food. Some people, they will send you messages on your social media. Say, this message, if you don't send it to 200 people within 3 hours, this is what happened. That is an intimidation. It is witchcraft. It is a blackmail. It is what? I delete it. I don't send to any people. You can't force me to send anything. You can't blackmail me. It's a blackmail. It's what? It's a pure blackmail. I'm telling you the truth. But that was, I delete it. You can't force me. You can't force me. Anything of domination, intimidation, blackmail is a weapon of witchcraft. What's the time now? Huh? How many minutes? Wow, that was good. We managed our time very well. That's good. That's good. Praise the name of the Lord. Don't blackmail me. Say you have to send to 30 people. No, I won't send to anybody. I will delete it. How many people have you sent our own church flyer? Our flyer about our program. How many people have you sent it to yourself? We already have the flyer for what you call it. For the vigil. How many people did you send it to? Okay, the vigil, virtual Bible actors of the night and the activities. Friday, November 20th. You are not sending it. Next Sunday is dream deliverance. Dreams, causes, and the battle of life. Because the dream you have is an indicator of the battle you are passing through. Praise the name of the Lord. Those are the things we want to share next week. That is, the kind of dreams you have, they show the kinds of what? The battle you are passing through. The environment you see yourself in the dream is the environment of your battle. Through your dream, you can know your battle. Those are the things we want to talk about and pray so that you can receive instant victory. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. The Lord will help me in Jesus' name. The Lion of Judah has broken every yoke. He has given me the victory again, again. The Lion of Judah has broken every yoke. He has given me the victory again, again. The Lion of Judah has broken see what God will do in your life. It's not prayer and fasting alone. You need these practical steps. I've seen so many that join multi-level marketing, wasting their times. They join multi-level, they say, they make people to sell what nobody is buying at high prices. No. If you join this, how many people, okay, tell me in your skill, how many people have done this multi-level marketing and become so big? Tell me. They make people to join what you call, what nobody is buying at high prices. They'll go for me and be shouting. I was there when they came and market, so when I look at it, I said, okay, I will pray about it. I dropped it over there. Praise the name of the Lord. You see, you lose your sufficient money. Say, buy the 60,000. You pay 60,000 and they give you. They give you products that nobody is buying at a very high prices. Think. What did they say? Your brain is for thinking. That's what God gave you. You have your judgment concerning what I am teaching. But these are practical realities. These are what? If you like. You have your own brain. That's why God put in the brain. Okay? They make it to say when nobody is buying at high prices. Say, no. When you get to this level, 3 people under you, you get income. It's like that. Am I saying the truth? You blame me about it. Pastor, shout hallelujah. You see, they are now looking at other dimensions of prosperity theology. God said, come and give. By the time you prosper, you're going to do well for the church. We need money now. And these are practical things. If anybody says, come and get money, let's go back and pay. Something they are selling, nobody is very attentive. How many have you bought? Okay? How many have you bought? If you buy this sort of money, you all know where your money will go. And before, if I take 10 kilometers to people, the owner of your body is so nice that they are attracting you. They make you to sell products that nobody is buying at high prices. And you pay subscription money, and when you finish it, think about this thing as you go. If you have any questions, call me. If you have any send message to me. If it's the man, you do the man's prayer for me. If it is money matter,
Talk to me about it. It is time for China to be restored.
I do not hear your amen.
Amen.
If government is not giving us stimulus,
yes, we should be able to stimulate ourselves. Stimulate ourselves to prosperity. Amen.
Don't come and market me with any multi-level marketing product. I won't answer you.
Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
A lot of people, they also engage in prime purchase of second items.
What did I call it?
You buy some hand product before you know it, you drive it to that place, it's pack up. Get experts to come and help you look at that same hand car you want to buy. There are Christians that are packing vehicles and they sell it. Christians, they do it also too. You lose money, you lose time. So vehicles, by the time you buy some hand, you will be able to call that they have problems. If you want to buy some hand machines, make sure you bring experts. Okay? If you engage in black purchase, you lose your time and you waste your money. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Close your eyes. You are going to pray. Say, anti-progress power in my environment. In the name of Jesus. Pray. In Jesus' mighty name, pray. Two more prayer. Say, every power that says, over his dead body shall I make progress. Every power that says, over his dead body shall I make progress. So shall he be. In the name of Jesus. Pray. Every power that says, over his dead body shall I make progress. So shall he be. So shall he be. In Jesus, so we pray. Write that prayer point down in 5 minutes. When you get to write it down. Every power that says, over in that body shall I make progress, so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Write it down, write it down, write it down. When you get to, give me 5 minutes. This is the last prayer point. Write short, this is the last prayer point. Evil power of my father's house, pushing me away from my breakthroughs.